Hello guys, how are you doing? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Salsa and Bachata Moves, where I break down salsa and bachata moves. And also welcome to my dance school expressions. I'm Alexandros, I come from the island of Cyprus, and I have this channel for the past 6 years. There's over 700 videos plus that you can go out and check out. But if you don't want to get lost in the big mess of combinations and footwork and isolations like today's lesson, I suggest go to my channel, click on playlist, and find the playlist that you want to learn. Salsa moves, bachata moves, body isolations, musicality, footwork, and my new series that I'm doing now, Salsations. This is, I think, choreography number 5, if I'm not mistaken. We have 10th of February, 2021. We're still in quarantine, and this gives me a good chance to every day get up in the morning, do a few eights of choreography, clean it up a little bit, change it, make sure that I have some of the before, also, especially the reverse shoulders. I'm an advocate for that you have to learn it. I think I didn't put it on the previous choreography, I'm sorry. But each one has something new. This one, I would like to call it the Michael Jackson, because the beginning is inspired completely by Michael Jackson, except the fact that we're gonna shake our bum bum. Now, for you that are coming first time here, I'm doing for 1 week every day one lesson called Salsations. It is combinations of isolations. So if I do a hand wave and then a body wave and then a circular wave up, I have done 3 different isolations, combining them together without or minimal or no footwork. Okay, now let's get started. First, I show it back and front, because as isolations you want to see the front body doing it as well. And then after we do the count, if you guys like the move or you find a move that you like a little bit, stay around for the lessons, because I break it very much in detail and I have helping videos that I'm going to put here and in the description, where you can go and find 20 minutes of explanation to do the reverse shoulders if you've never done them, because I just throw them in the choreography, and if you want to progress and do it, you'll have to do that. Okay, let's get started with the lesson. Enough, yep, yep. I know. I just want people to know what's really happening, and I hope you like all this. If you do all 7 of Salsations, you will have so much in your vocabulary to translate music. Let's go for number 5 choreography of Salsations, the Michael Jackson style. And 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 3, and 5, 6, 7. Okay, I think that was slow enough, and you've seen quite nice moves there. Some of them, out of the last 4, they don't exist except in this one. Some of them do exist, like the side wave, but it's only the second one in choreography, and I think you should practice that one a lot. And by the way, I'll start from now. The side wave is right here. Comes towards the end of the choreography, so you might need to click on the info icon again when you want to go and see it. Click on it. I'll analyze it, of course, here as well. Now, let's do the front part. 1, 2, 3. Ready? Halfway through. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, and 7. Ow! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here there's no space, guys, sorry. I'll do that last one again. You see, I'm not gonna cut them out. Right here, I was gonna hit on the back of the bench. So I'll come a little bit more to the front. This is just a spin, but I put it in because when you bend down, it gives a little bit of isolation movement as well. Wow! And I think it was nice to add it in. Okay, so that was the front view with the Shiri finale. But when we do it to music, I'll do it this way so you'll see it full powered on. Okay, let's get started with the lesson. Guys, if you find even one thing, stick around. I think you're gonna enjoy it. Now, let's start the lesson. Basic. One, two, three, five, six, seven. Second time around, only half a basic. One, two, three. Then I'll turn this way so you see. First thing you wanna do is try this part of your foot, of the outside, to go as high as possible without twisting your body too much. Okay, as high as it can go. And then there's a ball falling, boom, boom, and you kick the ball. Boom, boom, okay? So you go in five, boom, boom. Now, this is an illusion, beautiful illusion from Michael Jackson. When he kicks, he's not in this level when he goes down, and then down, and more down. His trick is, boom, boom, and when he goes to the first twist of the knees, he's already in a lower position, so when he opens his knees up, it's only the knees and there is not a second lowering. So you don't get this, boom, 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 boom. You see, tap, tap, you get this, boom, 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 boom. You see the last knees, there was no lowering. Rewind that, learn it, it's quite cool. Of course, usually, ow, he does a jump, boom, boom, pa, pa, boom. And then he grabs his thingies. Here we can do it more Latino, have it more here instead of grabbing our thingies. Maybe he grabs his thingies to reach that high. I mean, he's a high singer. All right, so now that you've seen it from this side, let's do it. One, two, three, four. Basic again. One, two, three, and five, six, seven. Now we do four jumps. I apologize if the jumps shake the camera, guys. It's on a tripod, so when you do this, it's... Okay, so one, two, three, four. I use the ball of my foot to swivel and I launch myself forward. But the trick is to make it not to look like you're doing it with your feet. It's just like something is pushing you behind. At the same time, to make it more Latino and not Jackson-wise, we want to be doing circular action. If you check on the previews, here I'll put the playlist of the last four choreographies. You can go check them out. We have, almost in all of them, how to do circular action with the hips. Very important. So as you go forward, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Lift up. Again, this is an exercise for inductors. If you can't be that open and close in, that means you need to work them out. So go find a slippery floor, put your socks on, open up as much as your shoulders and close it in. Keep on doing that for maybe a whole song, 3 minutes, not a big one. And then relax. Next day again, and slowly, slowly, you come to even a huge opening and have enough power to close. So, important here to say that it goes one, two, three, three, five, seven. That's our next three accents. So that's our next three moonwalks. Three, five, seven. And you're like, hey Alex, I didn't sign up for a moonwalk. Okay, or maybe some of you are like, hell yeah, I'm gonna learn the moonwalk from a Latin channel. Yes, why not? How many times you roll the lady back and you walk with her, but you can actually moonwalk with her. That makes a difference. All right, I just put it in for fun. It's not much of an isolation, but of course you can do also the shoulders moving forward and back and get it happening into a more isolation. I'll explain it a little bit quick and I'll tell you the one trick that everybody does wrong, and if you do it correctly, your moonwalk will look amazing. Okay, here's the starting position. Ball of the foot on the left and hold flat foot here. Okay, starting position is not the same as going. But anyway, we're gonna use our butt cheeks and our hamstrings to pull the leg back as possible. That's my natural opening, I can't do it anymore. Then, I'm going to put the heel down and then lift the other one. So this is straight, this is bent, and this one is on the ball of the foot. And now you see it's more in front from the beginning. You don't start from the beginning with the foot forward. But that's okay, I'm still gonna drag it in flat. Drag it, pass it all the way to the other foot. And then when I come to my final point, I'm going to switch so I can drag the other one, switch. Now I'm doing it really big. You can do it big, you can do it small, but big is the best way to learn it. Now here's the one trick, guys, that not many people tell you. Look at this one. Nice and smooth, yeah? Yeah, small one, no problem. Check this out, the same thing with a small difference. What makes it look bad? Everybody that's pulling their foot back, they're too much in a hurry to lift their back heel to get balance. You have to wait until your stride, that means your natural opening comes, then switch when you're ready. Don't switch beforehand and keep dragging in the moonwalk on the ball of your foot. The drag is always the heel and the ball of the foot on the floor. Then you switch and it stays on the floor until the last minute. If you lift sooner, then you don't get that result. But anyways, after going forward, 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 I'll do it from the side. One, two, lift up on the ball of the left foot and push backwards. So it's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I know I'm doing that a little bit mechanic, but you can go a little bit more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Put some shoulders in. And of course, you can start with a small one and then do a bigger one to finish. Really doesn't matter. I hope you guys actually liked it that I put the moonwalk and not hated it. Let's continue. All right, from the top once and then we'll go on. One, two, three, one more basic, here we go. One, two, three, and five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We're gonna go to the side now. You see, bend the knee and straighten out the right. Then move to the side, then move to the side. That's three times, four beats. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four. Of course, it looks quite boring. So I'm gonna put a video there, how to do the reverse shoulders in complete detail. Excuse me. The reverse shoulders basically is the right shoulder goes forward. It starts from an up position and it goes forward, down and back. And the other one starts from a lower position and goes forward, but from down up. So you see this one comes from down up and the other one comes from the front. And then you have what we call reverse shoulders. They're very nice, especially from reggaeton. So when you're going to the side, again, if you didn't pick it up, of course, in this very fast explanation, I click on the eye icon there. It's gonna show all the videos that I put. I can only put up to five, but the shoulders are so important. I say it almost in every lesson. So now that we're going here, we're gonna have our hands here or here if you like, and we're gonna go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now this is what I like to call the side wave up, which I don't really see it anywhere. I only see the basic and the basic down, but I have a lesson for that as well. I'll put it right here if you want it more analyzed. But starting from here, one shoulder movement, two shoulder movements, one shoulder movement, two shoulder movements, again here two, and then pull yourself fast in and bring your knees to the right. Now when you bring your knees to the left, make sure you straighten out your knees and you bend from your waist so the waist sticks out there. So it's basically bent knees, straight knees to this position. Now the only thing, two things left to do is your hips have to come to the center and your upper body move out of the center and then bring it back in. And then you have one, two, three, four. A side body wave. So one, two, three, four. If you make it a little bit more flexy, you see my shoulders? And sometimes I like to do like a cartoon, ding, 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 ding. In the previous one, I think I taught it boom, boom with an accent. here, you can just shake the head a little bit. Okay, that's it. Again, go check it out if you want it in more depth detail. And if you haven't learned it from here, it's about 15 minutes long showing how to do it. And you can continue this choreography. Now, after this, guys, I came a little bit more back so we have more space. We're just gonna be going cross, cross, out to diagonal and coming back. You see my hip going a little bit and coming back? It's not a necessity because you're actually moving your upper body, but it's nice if you extend a little bit more. And when we go forward, we're gonna add the isolations of backward shoulders. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. At the same time, you're going to open up your arms in a position like so. So one is about 90 degrees in relation to my body and parallel to the ground, but this one has a more angle into it, just like flying wings for humans. And when we go to the side, we fold them in, let your wrists fold in, and push your chest out, and let your wrists fold out. Okay? So the wrists are the one giving a lot of the implications. If you just do this, doesn't work. And also the body movement forward and back, which you can get from extending this way. So after the side wave, 1, 2, 3, 4, close and open, 5, 6, 7. Ladies can also do a figure eight, or you can just go out and come back in. Then we repeat it one more time because it's so cool. And then we open up to the side and close. Now this one is a basic to a body wave, or a body wave basic. Instead of going one, I go on the ball of my foot, 1, 2, and 3. That's 4 steps. 1, push back, 2, and 3. So after you went out like this and in, you're gonna go 1, 2, and 3. Of course, from the side, you can see it better than here. So boom, boom, bra, bra, boom, boom, bra, bra, there. 1, 2, and 3. Move to the side again. Again, I'm taking for the third time, I think, this position because it's from devoted to Michael Jackson position of doing the kicks. So we're gonna go here. Whoa, just go around. Okay, let's try it again. 5, 6, 7. Now check it out. First the toes, toes, heels, toes. And when the heels come in, use them to do a body weight upwards. If I have enough info cards left, I'll put right now also how to do body weights from up, down, and down, up. Okie dokie. So from here, we're going in, body weight up, tum tum. I'll show a little bit this way because, this way because I'm actually doing back, front, back, boom. So this hits a body wave, the head comes out, boom, boom, and it bounces up by 7. So you're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah? And to finish it off, prepare your hands to the left and your foot to the right, touching. 1, 2, 3, 4, turn your body. And now as you turn, let it roll in and turn around. Just before you finish, bend your knee and twist out the foot and go into your basic. So you will go 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3. One more time. 1, 2, 3. As the preparation, in, out, turn, whoa, into the basic. So you gotta expand your body here as well. So we do have a little bit of isolation there going, and that's why I decided to put it in plus. It's a nice turn. Okay, guys, let's do it one last time from the beginning. Slow count, a little bit, no, actually medium count, because we're gonna do it to music. Let's go from the top. 5, 6, pause the video if you don't remember. Memorize the whole thing so you don't run after the step. And then press play and dance it with me. Basic. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Ready? 2, 3, 5, 6, and 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7. And One, two, three, four. Oh! One, two, three, four, five, six. Wave it. One, two, three, and four. Six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, six, seven, and one, two, three, five, six, seven, and one, two, three, five, six, seven. Okay, guys, I hope you like it so far. This is choreography number five. I have two more for tomorrow and the day after. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon so you get notification when I release the video. I always do it at nighttime. Sorry for the quality. I have a mobile, not a good camera, and the mobile is about 5-6 years old. And I try in the editing to put more light and more color. If you'd like to support with a donation, you can check in the link in the description for PayPal safe donations. Now that we've learned it, how about we go to music? Okay guys, that's it, the end of the lesson. I always leave a little message at the end. Once again, if you like these ones, I'm uploading them, I'm not seeing a lot of response from it, but because I also stopped sharing in 30 Facebook groups my every video that I release. So if you like, you can go to my Facebook group, there I do release them, but I'm gonna leave it for about a month without sharing and let algorithm of YouTube take care of the videos for a while and see what happens. Because after 700 videos, you would expect a little bit more people, more subscribers. But the people we do get, we appreciate you a lot. And many of you have given donations, bought products from us, gave us support, gave us comments, good criticism. And we're just getting better because of you. Thank you very much. And there is only, this is number five, there's only two more lessons left for salsations, and then we're going back to our routine of one salsa combination, one footwork combination, and then we're gonna have another bachata combination. All right, thank you very much for watching. See you on the next video.